Hello all. Tonight I got this Fisher 283 system that I got and fixing up for a friend of mine. It's got the ST-832 speakers, FM-270A tuner that came with it. EQ-272 weak graphic equalizer. This is not part of the system, but I'm going to be using it. It's a DAC-914. And this here is a turntable model MT-728. Let's fire it up.
'99.9 The Hawk.
I just can't believe it's coming down here. I'm down in the basement. All I got is this little. It's actually not a bad sounding set, but the signal's a little bit weak. Here you go. That's the only local station I have it. Jazz. I actually rebuilt the crossover in these speakers. Now the Fisher ST-832s kind of have a bad rep. They're known for their the bass on them is just like any other Fisher speakers. The bass on these speakers is phenomenal. It's awesome, powerful, boomy. I shouldn't say boomy. It is very controllable. And it sounds good at any level pretty much. But these ones are known for lacking high frequency response. And I actually rebuilt, I'll show you. I think it has to do with these garbage crossovers they have in them. Those are for the mid-ranges. Yeah, and these ones here were for the... Yeah, they were for the tweeters. And these ones were for the mid-ranges, and... All the resistors were the same value. Come on, damn it. The iPhone is supposed to have good cameras on them. To me, it's freaking mediocre at best. There you go. 2.2 ohm resistors. Now, just to give an idea of the clarity and what kind of sound you get out of it, I will do a CD test. Let's compact disc first. And I do not have the equalizer turned on right now. Go through the tape monitor. I will turn it on. But like I said, I like to test things out flat first. It's actually kind of funny on that. I'm from Levittown originally. I got picked this stereo set up in Coldell. Just kind of ironic that was back there, honestly. Thought it was kind of weird. Drivers work now pretty good. Trying to get a decent listening angle. I got the CD player off of eBay knowing that it was broken. I was able to fix it, needed new belts. Had two Backstreet Boys CDs in there. I threw them away and I messaged the seller. I said, yeah, I got the CD player fixed, easy fix. I just had to throw the garbage CDs that were out in it. if I was a CD changer and someone loaded Backstreet Boys up in there, I wouldn't want to play them either. I'd break down too. I'm gonna pause quick and actually I don't think I can pause. I'm gonna grab an album. We're gonna try that out. Yeah, I don't want to risk doing that on this phone because I'm not exactly sure. I don't know, for an iPhone, this thing kind of leaves a little bit to be desired. Oh, the picture sound is pretty good. Functionality wise, it kind of sucks. I go over here and grab a freaking album. I got a lot of projects going on right now. All right, what do we got? I don't want to get nailed for Farmer. I'm pretty sure that's what would happen. Gotta grab something on A&M. Black Sabbath. Right, I'll do some Nazareth. I'll be good with that. I'm gonna set these down for 1 second. Check this thing out. This is so cool. Linear tracking. Record. See how good I am at lining it up still? Do I still got it? That's about right. Oh, I'm good. I said in another one of the videos, because you always get that one guy has to comment and call Fisher speakers junk. They're not junk. They're I wasn't gonna sit here and say they're audiophile grade and that they're the best thing ever, because they are not that. But for the price, you can get a decent set of speakers like such as these for as cheap, sometimes cheaper than $50. I say they're worth probably about $100 to $120. That's a fair asking price. If they're working properly. For $9, reload the crossovers. You have an excellent set of speakers. They're gonna last you freaking decades. And they crank and they do sound decent. They can, and set up right with a proper amp, they can sound pretty good. The pros, awesome bass response. Some of the best bass response I've ever heard, especially if you're a bass head and you like to feel your music in your chest when the bass notes hit. Excellent speakers. I will always run a pair of Fishers with 15-inch woofers, no matter what kind of fancy. Like, I have a pair of JBL L100 speakers, and I AB them. I have these on there, and the JBL L100s have great bass too. But I'll always run a set of Fishers with 15s, just for that extra, you know, the pounding. If you wanted to do that. The cons, they are very finicky about what you hook them up to. That'd be about the only cons I can come up with. And these speakers, some of these Fisher models, these ones are kind of like one of the, they're not the best. I like the, personally, I like the ST-843, ST-845, and STV-893 and STV-890 for 15. And personally, but the ST-830s are really, and the ST-828s are real good too. These ones here are a little bit finicky, but they can sound really good if hooked up properly and if well maintained, and especially if you upgrade them. Like I said, I rebuilt these crossovers and that, and if you put better drivers in, you can have a very, very, very good sounding set of speakers. And these are rated at 100 watts per channel. I think the receiver is 100 watts per channel. These speakers can handle 100 watts peak. allegedly. I think they can handle more than that, personally. These are the specs on the back of the receiver. 470 watts of power consumption. I'd say probably between 100 and 120 watts per channel. Like I said, one of their, it's not their most fancy model, but it's a decent one. The lower end models have the slider for volume. It's not as nice as the 854 with the light up sliders. It's Equalizer's not the nicest one either, but it's effective. It doesn't have a spectrum analyzer or the lit up sliders, but it's effective. It does the same job and it does it well. That's so cool. I've never had a linear track in one before. That's neat. And it does have, I do have the grills for the speakers too. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Oh, these are all some of my parts units and shit like that I have. This is the cassette deck that came with it. It's a little bit beat up and it doesn't work. I'm not even gonna bother messing with it, to be completely honest with you. And these here are also a sign of it not being a high-end model. When they have these stupid plugins, the only component over here that has that is a tuner. The tuner has one of those too, which makes this tuner completely useless unless you have the matching amp to go with it. Which, whatever, it doesn't really matter. And like I said, the CD player is not part of this system. And actually, neither is the Equalizer. It just so happened I had one with the match with a, you know, a similar model number on it. But yeah, that's that. And grab the covers quick. One's missing the Fisher logo, unfortunately, but I don't think my buddy's really gonna care about that. And so it's a tape monitor, and you gotta watch because the Equalizer will kick off every time you, which is the one thing I don't like. Tape monitor doesn't stay on. So it's just like a regular function, but that's alright. Just remember if you need the EQ to turn it on. I usually don't run the EQ anyway. I usually use mine for the spectrum analyzer because it looks cool. And sometimes I up the highs or up the lows a little bit, depending on what I'm listening to. Hey guys, as usual, thanks for watching. And dude, I can't wait till summer. This cold weather's killing me. And I'll see you next time. Let me know what you think about this here Fisher set. Like I said, it works pretty good, and for the price you pay for it, you can get a good system like this probably roughly $300. It's probably what it's worth, you know, in working and cleaned up and upgraded order. Like, if I needed a good sounding stereo system, I would have no problem giving somebody $300 for that. Has an auxiliary input so I can hook my phone up or, you know, run a TV off of it or some kind of streaming service. FM radio, CD changer, turntable, cassette deck input if I needed it. That's everything you need right there. And, So, I will defend these Fisher systems, you know, to the death. Are they the best thing that exists? Absolutely not. But for the price, they are the best thing, in my opinion, the best systems you can get for the price. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching, and let me know what you think.